Hi everyone, I am Dr. Saravanan, final year PG from the AVMC, Pondicherry. Today my topic for a paper presentation is a gastric microbursar under the guidance of Dr. Professor Hitish. Bazaars are a collection of non-digestible matters that usually accumulate in the stomach and can extend up to the small bowel. Microbazaars are the concretions of air and they are very rare presentation and usually found in young psychiatric females. They should be diagnosed and managed early despite their rarity so as to prevent complications like obstruction, perforation and bleeding. Bazaar is a rare cause of intestinal obstruction with an incidence of less than 1%. Human hair is resistant to digestion and peristaltic movement because of its smoothness. Continuous ingestion of air over a period of time can lead to their infection along with mucus and food material into the stomach. In some cases, however, the trichobazaar extends through the pylorus into the jejunum, ileum or even colon. This condition is called Rapunzel syndrome, which was first described by Vaughan. The patient, 18-year-old female patient, presented with chief complaints of on and off vomiting for 6 months and loss of appetite for 4 months and pain and lump in the abdomen for 2 months. On general physical examination, the patient was thin-built, well-looking female. Abdominal examination revealed a well-defined, smooth and a hard intra-abdominal lump of 6 into 9 centimeters in the epigastric region. She had no history of fever and the pulsate was normal and the blood pressure was 110 bar 70 millimeter mercury. On a systemic examination, the CVS and respiratory systems were normal. Patient was then referred to radiology department from surgery to rule out any splenic mass. First, the patient was patient came to X-ray department. AP abdomen radiograph showing dilatation of the stomach by an opacity that occupies almost all of its gastric region with air around and caudal displacement of the transverse colon compatible with the gastric mass. Then ultrasound of the mass was done and it shows a linear echogenic mass in the form of an arc causing posterior acoustic shadowing. Then patient was referred to CT abdomen. Abdominal scan with contrast medium shows the gastric lumen is occupied by heterogeneous material with predominance of low density mass arranged in concentric rings of different densities and surrounded by oral contrast medium. Abdominal scans with contrast medium shows extension of gastric lumen material towards the first and second portions of duodenum, favoring for Rapunzel syndrome. The patient was then taken for a gastrostomy. This is a specimen of a trichobazaar extracted from a gastrostomy in which a cluster of air is observed that adopts a contour of the stomach and the proximal duodenum. Diagnosis. Diagnosis is the large trichobazaar extending till the second part of duodenum known as Rapunzel syndrome. This is a rare cause of intestinal obstruction with an incidence of less than 1%. Patient may be asymptomatic or exhibit non-specific symptoms such as epigastric pain, bloating, nausea, vomiting, weight loss, or gastrointestinal bleeding. Abdominal CT scans are the study of choice for identification and evaluation of complications, as well as to detect additional bazaars in the rest of the gastrointestinal tract. Ultrasound has been described as a characteristic finding. The linear arc-shaped echogenic band with posterior acoustic shadow. The trichobazaar is lodged in the stomach and its distal part extends distally to the small intestine or descending colon. It is known as Rapunzel syndrome. Other complications that may appear are perforation, peritonitis, or formation of abscess. The differential diagnosis or remains of food in the stomach or fecal matter in the intestine or fecal sign seen in the intestinal obstruction. Treatment of trichobezer is surgical. Laparotomy is the method of choice by means of which gastrostomy and mass extraction are performed. In some cases, laparoscopy and endoscopy is occasionally done, depending upon the size of the mass. Psychiatric assessment is needed for patient support and a relapse of prevention. Diagnostic images are basis in the diagnosis of a bezer because due to its non-specific symptoms and it is not clinically suspected. Diagnosis of a trichobezer is possible only on imaging. Psychiatric and medical sequelae of a trichotillomania should not be underestimated. Early diagnosis and treatment is really important to save the patient's life from recurrence. Laparotomy is considered the best treatment option, although pharmacotherapy and behavioral assessment plays a useful role in patient's management. These are my references. Thank you.